When you have, when to, these are the arteries where you will measure the heart rate or pulse rate, temporal, carotid, brachial, radial, ulnar, femoral, popliteal, dorsal pedal and posterior tibia. These are the places you feel for the heart rate. When you are taking the heart rate, the important principles are you can take by using three fingers. When you use fingers, it is a touch and proprioception feeling. What you have to take in account for measuring the heart rate. When you are putting the stethoscope, the chest piece of the stethoscope, you will be listening. That means you will be hearing the heart sound. So these are the two mechanisms or two ways you can measure the pulse rate. The most common and traditional way of measurement is by keeping the fingers. When you keep the fingers on the patient, the distal fingers, that is the ring finger and the index finger, has to palpate the artery, the continuation of the artery. The middle finger, it has to feel for the labdhak sounds of the hearts, the beating sounds of the hearts. That is second principle. The third principle, when you are taking the heart rate, the person should be in supine position or in a sitting position with support, complete support. They should not be in standing or moving positions. So they should be in sitting. After sitting or after lying down also, you have to wait for 2 to 5 minutes so that the system will calm down. The person will be at the stage of rest. At that particular time, if you measure the heart rate, you will get the clear values. That is called resting heart rate. That is called resting heart rate. You have to make the person lie down or sit comfortably and for 2 to 5 minutes, then you will get the resting heart rate. So for one measurement, the body position is different. For example, temporal artery, it is in supine. So there is different positions. Whatever the position, the important thing is patient should be calm. They should be calm and the surrounding should be also calm. So when you are measuring the heart rate, this is the third principle. First principle, two methods. Second principle, the fingers, how to feel. The third principle, a good position and calm environment. The fourth principle, when you are taking the heart rate, you have to take continuously for 1 minute. That means you put your mobile phone or your watch, start the button system or stopwatch, and you have to measure continuously for 1 minute. For 1 minute, how many times you feel the labdhak, that many times you have to record. The most normal rating is from 72 to 80. That is the normal heart rate for anybody. So this is how you have to measure. Now I will show the practical. One person here on the bed. So when you are measuring temporal, the position of the patient is supine. The head is turned to one side. Okay. Your three fingers, you just first feel the broader area. Feel the broader area, all the area. Okay. Now you will get at one place, especially in the anterior to the ear, just above anterior to the ear, you will get for the heartbeat. See, now I am getting the heartbeat. You can feel? Yes, even I can feel. So now I can feel. So I will make my watch ready. Now I be ready, and when you are important step, Shabab, when you are measuring the heart rate, don't look at the watch. What happens when you look at the watch? You start counting the seconds.
Yes.
Okay? So that time don't see the seconds. You start and you see here. Or you feel here. If you see here, then your numbers will change. You start counting the seconds. You don't count the heart rate. So here the important thing is you have to count the heart rate, not the seconds. So I keep the fingers again. Okay. No.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 6, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77. That's it. So for 1 minute, I have 77. So that is the normal. He is in the normal heart. That is for the temple. Okay? Now the next one is carotid. So when you are measuring the carotid, you have to be very careful, because in the carotid artery there are some receptors. There are some receptors are there in the carotid artery. When you press them hard, they will get activated and the whole system will change. The heart rate system will change. So for precautionary purposes, I will show, but I don't want you to practice. Okay, because you may just poke it onto the skin and you may activate the chemical receptors which are there in the carotid artery. So for the carotid artery, the position should be, head should be little extension. So we keep the head in extension. Okay, now this is the trachea. Can you see, this is the trachea, hyoid bone. Onto the hyoid bone, sternocleidomastoid muscle. So in between, can you see the movement of the skin? Can you show? Okay.
Over here.
No, no, I am feeling here. The skin movement is here. If you come this side, you will see it very clearly. Can you see the movement? Oh, you have to come from this. Yes. Can you see now? So this area, so again same, you will put the stopwatch and you will measure. This is for the carotid artery. Where is the position? Trachea, sternocleidomastoid, between that. That is the position for carotid artery. The next artery is brachial artery. For the brachial artery, you have to make the elbow in extension. The whole hand should be supported. The cuboidal fossa, medial border. Here. Okay, so that is cuboidal fossa, medial border. You can feel your own. So next one is ulnar and radius. So which side is ulna? Medial side is ulna or radial side is ulna?
Ulna.
Ulna is medial. Shabab! Ulna is medial or lateral?
Medial.
The radius bone is? Lateral. So, where to feel for radial artery? Laterally or medially?
Medial.
Just now you said medial is ulna. How you will feel medial to the radial artery? So, this is the wrist. Okay, wrist line. Can you see the wrist line? The wrist line, lateral side. You will feel the radial artery. Okay, same. So you should not keep like this. You keep in a supported position, then you feel. Okay, or you support the hand, then you feel. So lateral side, you feel for the radial artery. Medial side, you feel for the ulnar artery. Okay, so now you come and practice for temporal, brachial, ulnar and radial. The principles are same. Patient should be in comfortable position. You can measure by fingers or you can measure by the stethoscope chest piece. When you measure by stethoscope chest piece, it is hearing. When you are keeping fingers, it is touch and proprioception. The area should be calm, whatever you are measuring. The surrounding should be calm, and two fingers will palpate the artery, one finger will feel for the sound. Keep the stopwatch for 1 minute. How for 1 minute completely, how many number of beatings you will get, that is the heart rate or pulse rate. Why you have to measure for whole 1 minute is because you have to know the rhythm. Sometimes heart rate goes faster, sometimes it becomes smaller. So if you measure only half or 15 seconds and calculate by 4, it will become wrong. The beatings will become wrong. That's why you have to measure for complete 1 minute. Okay? So this is the method. That's it. We have femoral, popliteal, posterior tibial, dorsal pedal. There are the four arteries. We are not going to measure femoral because this is next to the little private parts. So only in the emergencies they put the injections there. So we are not going to measure. Okay? So what we see is popliteal. So this is popliteal fossa. Silence. This is popliteal fossa. In the popliteal fossa, in the middle. I can feel in the middle. Okay, so that is popliteal. The next one is behind the lateral malleolus. See, this is medial, this is lateral. Behind the lateral malleolus. Okay, this is posterior tibial, then normal supine, high supine. So extensor tendon, medial to the extensor tendon.
This is what this?
Dorsal pedal.
Big toe,
extensor tendon, medial to the extensor tendon. Then the picture, this is posterior tibial. Dorsal pedal, no, it is here. Okay, dorsal pedal is here, not here. Okay? In the picture, it is showing for this.
What's called
in the picture? It is showing for this. I am showing here. Same. Okay. So it is dorsal pedal. Dorsal pedal. Okay, posterior tibial, dorsal pedal or dorsalis pedis, anything is same. Dorsal pedal, posterior tibial, popliteal. These are the another three positions. Tibial, tibia, posterior, posterior tibial. Dorsum, this is dorsiflexion, dorsal, pedal or pedis artery. Okay, popliteal fossa, popliteal, the middle of the popliteal. Okay, so that is about these three fingers.